The Dominican Republic is located within the Caribbean islands, particularly on a small island referred to as Hispaniola. The Dominican Republic shares Hispaniola with Haiti and covers almost two-thirds of the island spread over an area of nearly 18,000 square miles. Of those 18,000 square miles, the Dominican Republic has 1,000 miles in beaches with numerous beach resorts the vacationer might find appealing. Of course, beaches are not the only thing that the island has to offer, as there are four mountain ranges located throughout the island. Among them are Pico de Horta, the tallest mountain peak located in the Caribbean. An obvious potential business is opening up a resort, as this is a good idea that attracts a lot of tourism. Another option could be opening up a fishing business, since the sea offers easy access. One should keep in mind, though, that owning a business or even conducting business here might be pricey due to the expenses of importing materials or exporting goods. The Dominican Republic is located within the Caribbean islands, so it is only natural that the climate is very warm. It is said that the average temperature is about 80 degrees Fahrenheit. Its cooler months are November to January. High levels of participation can be experienced throughout May through July. The country is Roman Catholic and voodoo is secretly practiced. The Dominican Republic is like no other place because of its history and a result of unlikely mixtures of influence, blending with European, African, and Native Tenino Indian cultures. Christopher Columbus's brother discovered the land of the Dominican Republic. In 1844, a revolt overthrows Haitian president and Santo Domingo gains independence and becomes the Dominican Republic. And in 1906, the United States makes the Dominican Republic, I can't read that word. And then in 1906, still, the U.S. and the DR was for the U.S. to take over the DR's customs in exchange as a payoff for its debts. In 1916, the United States occupies the Dominican Republic with military government. 1924, the United States leaves and the Dominican Republic establishes democratically elected government. And in 1960, the OAS, severs diplomatic ties with the Dominican Republic. And in 2004, the DR becomes a part of the free trade agreement between the U.S. and five other Central American countries. The flag was adopted in 1844. It has three colors, red, white, and blue, all three which represent something. The red is to represent the blood of the heroes who freed them. Blue is to represent progress, liberty, and the God who will protect them. And the white is in the shape of a cross, which is to represent their fight and peace and unity among them. Located in the center of the flag is a coat of arms surrounded by both a laurel and a palm branch, located on the top of a blue ribbon that reads Dios Patria Libertad, and at the bottom is a red ribbon that reads República Dominicana. If you look closely at the shield, you can see that there is a Bible opened up to a page that reads Y a verdad nos hará librar. They have a good army, navy, air force, and over 4 million people are fit for service. And also the army acts the police, as when I was down there. Teachers do not make that a lot of money, and 40% of students don't even make it to high school. Whatever, we have baseball. They'll make it. The Dominican Republic is governed by a representative democracy. The current president is Mr. Dionaro Mendera, who will continue out his term until 2016 of August, unless something tragic happens to him. I doubt it. The government is divided into three branches: executive, judicial, and legislative. which basically is the same thing as the U.S. Yeah. They have few resources, but it is cheap labor, agriculture, tourism, and the economy could honestly be doing a lot better. It is important that if you are doing business with the Dominican Republic, that you shake their hand and you make eye contact with them. If you make eye contact with them, they'll think you're interested. It's good to make your appointments 2 to 3 weeks in advance by telephone, email, or fax. It's good to arrive on time, too. Dress appropriate and have a business card with one side in English and the other in Spanish. Hay algo que me gusta de ti. Y ese algo me encanta. Siento que eres...